نصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والضحى والليل إذا سجى صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمين المتين الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. As we all know that we have entered the sacred month of Rabi Al-Awwal, and from the very first day, we all be excited for the 12th of Rabi Al-Awwal. And we all start reciting the Durood-e Pak and Salatu Salam on our Holy Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Ta'ala wa Sallam. Not only this, we even decorate our houses and our streets as well. In the same way, when the time came for the rise of our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Ta'ala wa Sallam, many such dream events began to appear in the world around us, which gave the world the news of happiness and joy, that now the sun of prophethood is about to rise with all its splendor. Events like the death of Ashab-e Fil, the rejuvenation of the Arab land, their idol came crashing down to the ground, the fire that was lit by the Majusis in Persia, which had been burning for thousands of years, was extinguished in an instant, the sudden cracks in the 14 scriptures of the Kisra's palace, the 6 mile long and a 6 mile wide sea of Samawa between Hamdan and Qom in Iran suddenly dried up. In the same way, the sudden release of the dry river of Samawa between Syria and Kufa, a shining light coming from his mother's body which illuminates the palace of Basra. All these events are the links in the chain that became the bliss before his arrival and began to give the good news to the universe that the person who is going to rule the world is on the verge of arrival. In the same way, many strange events happened at the time of his birth as well. A hadith, which is quoted by Hazrat Imam Zurkari in his book from page number 212 to 216. The hadith is way too long to recite, and it is narrated by Khatib Baghdadi. He says that Bibi Amina radiallahu ta'ala anha, the mother of our Holy Prophet, she said that when the Holy Prophet was born, I saw a great change in weather. The clouds started gathering, along with that there was the roar of the horses and the sounds of birds flying, and the voices of some human beings as well. Then suddenly, the Prophet disappeared from my sight, and I heard an announcer announcing, فَسَمَّيْتُ مُنَادِيًا يُنَادِي تُوفُوا بِمُحَمَّدِ صَلَى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فِي مَشَّارِكِ الْأَرْضِ وَمَغَارِبِهَا وَأَدْخِلُوهُ الْبِحَارَ لِيَعْرِفُهُ بِإِسْمِهِ وَنَعْتِهِ وَسُورَتِهِ فِي جَمِيلِ الْأَرْضِ وَأَعْرِضُوا عَلَى كُلِّ رُوحَانٍ مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالطُّيُورِ وَالْوُحُوشِ. She said, and I heard an announcer announcing that take the Prophet throughout the east and the west, and take him through the seas as well, so that the whole universe may know his name, his form, and his attribute, and present him in front of all the jinns, the humans, the angels, the animals, and the birds. And further in the hadith it is said, وَأَعْتُوهُ خُلْقَ آدَمَ, and give him the form of Adam alayhislam, وَمَعْرِفَةَ شِيشَ, the knowledge of Hazrat Shish alayhislam, وَشُجَاعَةَ نُوحٍ, the courage of Prophet Nuh alayhislam, وَخُلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ, the seclusion of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhislam, وَلِسَانَ إِسْمَائِيلَ, the language of Hazrat Ismail alayhislam, وَرَزَاءَ إِسْحَاقَ, the acceptability of Hazrat Ishaq alayhislam, وَفَسَاحَةَ صَالِحِ, the eloquence of Hazrat Salih alayhislam, وَحِكْمَةَ لُوتَ, the wisdom of Hazrat Lut alayhislam, وَبُشْرَ يَعْقُوبَ, the good news of Hazrat Yaqub alayhislam, and Bushra means the one who bears the good news, وَشِدَّةَ مُوسَى, the intensity of Prophet Musa alayhislam, وَصَبْرَ أَيُّوبَ, the patience of Hazrat Ayyub alayhislam, wa ta'ata Yunus, the obedience of Hazrat Yunus alayhislam, wa jihad Ayyushi, the jihad of Hazrat Ayyushi alayhislam, wa sawta Dawud, the voice of Dawud alayhislam, wa hubba Daniyal, the love of Daniyal alayhislam, wa waqara Ilyas, the dignity of Hazrat Ilyas alayhislam, wa asmata Yahya, the infallibility of Hazrat Yahya alayhislam, wa zuhda Isa, the asceticism of Hazrat Isa alayhislam, wa aghmishuhu fi ikhlaqin nabiyyin, and adorn him with the perfections and good manners of all the prophets. And then Hazrat Amina radiallahu ta'ala anha says, the cloud parted away, and I saw him wrapped in a green silk cloth. And someone was shouting, Wallah, Wallah, Muhammad has been given control of the whole universe, and there is nothing left in the universe that is not in his position of power and dominion. And then she says, and when I saw his face, here Hazrat Amina is describing the beauty of a holy prophet. She says, when I saw his face, huwa kal qamari laylatal badri wa rihuhu yastau kal miskil uthfur. She said, his face was shining like the moon, and his body was smelling like pure fragrance of mushk. Allahu Akbar. Such was the beauty of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala wasallam. Then further in the hadith she say, then I saw that three men appeared. In one person's hand there was a silver mug. In other person's hand there was a plate of green emerald. In third person's hand there was a shiny ring. After washing the ring 7 times with the ring, he put a seal of Nabuwat between the two shoulders of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala wasallam, and then wrapped the Holy Prophet in a silk cloth and handed him over to me after a moment. Such an incident that happened at the time of the birth of a Holy Prophet, that even describing it gives us goosebumps. So after 25 days of the death of Ashabi Fil on 12th of Rabi Awwal, the son of Prophethood, the one for whom this whole universe was built, a Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was born. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Mawlana Muhammadin kama tuhibbu wa tarda bin tu salli alayhi. Salatum wa salamun alayka ya Habibi ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So the ayat kareema that I recited in the start, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَالْدُحَا وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى, by the morning brightness and the night as it settles. When we hear the interpretation of this verse, it says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saw allegiance of duha and saw allegiance of lail here in this verse. So what is the meaning of duha and what is the meaning of lail? Mufassiran kiram have made many tafsir on this. So Sheikh Abdul Aziz Muhaddis Dehelvi says that duha means the shiny morning, which means the shining and the bright face of a Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, and lail means the beautiful night, which means the beautiful dark hair of a Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. There is no person in this world who can match the beauty of a Holy Prophet. A writer writes these beautiful lines on Husn E Mustafa. He says, ye suna hai ke bahut ghor andheri hogi, par kabr ka khauf na rakhna ae dil, wahan sarkar ke chehre ki ziyarat hogi, aur kabhi yaseen, kabhi taha, kabhi wal lail aaya, jiski kasme mera rab khata hai, kitni dilkash mere mehboob ki surat hogi. Allah Akbar. Hazrat Jabir radiyallahu ta'ala says, an Jabir ibn Samura, qala raitu an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallama fi laylatil idhiyan, wa ja'altu undu ila rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallama wa ila al-kamari wa alayhi hullatun hamra'u fa idha huwa ahsanu 'indi min al-kamar. It is quoted from Tirmidhi Sharif, narrated by Hazrat Jabir ibn Samura. He says that I saw the Holy Prophet in the moonlit night. I saw him in the moonlight. Sometimes I would look at the Holy Prophet and sometimes I would look at the moon. And at that time the Holy Prophet was wearing dark colored clothes. So in the end I decided that the Holy Prophet was much more beautiful than the moon. Allahu Akbar. Moon is considered to be one of the most charming thing in this world, but Hazrat Jabir says a Prophet was much more charming than the moon. Subhanallah. Hazrat Sheikh Sadi says this lines on Husn Mustafa. He says, Balagal ulabe kamalihi, kashafat dujabe jamalihi, hasnat jamiyo khisalihi, sallu alayhi wa ali. Similarly, Hazrat Kaab ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala, while describing the description of the Holy Prophet, he says, and Kaab ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala, قَالَ كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إِذَا سُرَّ إِسْتِنَارَ وَجْحُهُ حَتَّى كَانَ وَجْحَهُ قِطْعَةٌ كَمَرٍ وَكُنَّا نَعْرِفُ ذَلِكَ. This is a muttafaq alayhi hadith narrated by Hazrat Kaab ibn Malik. He says that the face of the Holy Prophet, when he used to smile, when he used to blush, would shine brightly, like as if it's the source of light. The face of the Holy Prophet would look like a piece of a moon. Allah Akbar. And a poet who wrote this lines on Husn Mustafa, he says, Husn Yusuf par kati angushte zana, Husn Yusuf par kati angushte zana, sar kathate hain tere naam par martane arab. Hazrat Jabir radiyallahu ta'ala describes the beauty of a Holy Prophet and he says, an Jabir radiyallahu ta'ala anna nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallama lam yasluku tariqan fayatabahu ahadun illa arafa annahu qad salakahu min tibi arqihi aw qala min rihi arqihi. It is quoted from Mishkat Sharif, narrated by Hazrat Jabir radiyallahu ta'ala. He says that whichever way a Prophet used to pass or whichever way a Prophet used to walk, then whoever passes from that place after him, he could feel the fragrance of a Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, that the Holy Prophet went from this place. Subhanallah. But the most beloved hadith, the one which is very close to my heart, the best description I have ever read until now, is done by Hazrat Mabad radiyallahu ta'ala. Hazrat Mabad says, she describes the looks of a Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in such a great way. The hadith is way too long to recite, but the story is, while migrating to Medina, Prophet was accompanied by Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq and Amir bin Fuhaira, who was the slave of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, and the son of Uraykit, who guided them on their way. They passed by Mawad's house from the tribe of Quza. This was a time when people were suffering from severe droughts. Due to long travelling, they felt the need of water. They came at Hazrat Mawad's house, and Mawad would generously provide food and drink to the travellers who passed by. The Messenger of Allah and his companion had stopped at Hazrat Mawad's house to ask for some milk and dates. Sadly, she was unable to provide them with anything. The Prophet then saw a lonely goat within the shade of the camp. It was kept away due to its weakness. A Prophet asked, "Does this goat have any milk?" She replied, "She is too weak to have any." A Prophet asked again, "Will you allow me to milk her?" She replied, "My father and my mother be ransomed for you. If you see any milk in her, you may milk her." With the permission of Mawad, the Prophet passed his hand over the back and udder of the sheep. Then he asked for a container. He milked the goat and filled the container. Then he gave the milk to his companion to drink. And then he again milked the goat and filled the container for Mawad's family. And then a Prophet left. Later, when her husband came home and saw the container filled with the milk, he asked Mawad, "Where did this milk came from when there was no goat to milk?" Mawad said, "A blessed man passed by us." Abu Mawad asked his wife, "Describe the man." So she described a Prophet's beauty in such a charming way. And this can be related to the tafsir of Surah Duha. There are many hadiths which describes the beauty of a holy prophet, but these descriptions done by Hazrat Mawad radhiyallahu ta'ala anha is something where everyone can remember. And I would like everyone to just imagine the description in your head of a holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala wa sallam. She said, "I saw a man who is distinctly handsome and of beautiful countenance. He is well built, neither blemished by a big belly nor disfigured by an unusual small head. The pupils of his eyes are very dark. His eyelashes are very long and the area around his pupil is extremely white." Allahu Akbar. "His eyebrows are perfectly close. He has dark hair, a rather long neck and a thick beard. Whenever he remains silent, he is ever contemplative. And when he speaks, eminence and splendor exhibits in his words. His words are like pearls. He is a gifted orator whose words are neither too few nor too many. He has the most audible voice when he speaks." And the most mesmerizing line of this hadith is when she said, "Abhannas ajmalahu min ba'idin wa ahsanahu min karibin." When you look at him from far, he is the most handsome people from all of the people you have ever seen. And when you move closer to him, he is the most attractive person from all the person you have ever seen. You will never be tired from looking at him. He is the most handsome of the three people and the most important as well. He has companions who honor him. When he speaks, they listen to his words, and when he commands, they urge to carry out his order. They serve and gather around him. He never displeasures, nor does he harass anyone." Abu Mawad exclaimed, "Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, this is the man of Quraysh. If I see him, I follow him." And in another narration, Abu Mawad said, "I intend to follow him." They all went to Medina, embraced Islam, swore allegiance to the Prophet and stayed in his company as much as possible. With them was his brother Hubaysh ibn Khalid, who reported this narration. Such was the beauty of a beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala wa sallam. In a whole life, we get attached with people who disappoint us in some way or the other. But what we don't understand is we get attached with the wrong person. But if you get attached to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala wa sallam, I can guarantee you, he won't leave you in this world and in the year after. It is said in the hadith, "An Anas radiyallahu ta'ala an, qala qala Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, la yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna ahabba ilayhi min walidihi wa waladihi wa nasi ajmain." This is a muttafaq alayhi hadith. Hazrat Anas radiyallahu ta'ala an says that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, "None of you can be a mu'min. None of you can be a true believer unless you love me more than your parents, your children, and all the people you have known." How lucky are those people who got to see the beauty of our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. I pray to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to forgive all our sins and make us all the true lovers of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, and may he protect us all due to the blessing of this month of Rabiul Awwal. I shall end my speech here with these lines. Duniya ki har fiza mein hai ujala rasool ka, duniya ki har fiza mein hai ujala rasool ka, ye sari kainat hai sadqa rasool ka, khushboo gulab hai chehra rasool ka, aapko mubarak ho mahina rasool ka, وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم.